visible light, because like the dye set, this is the colored one, then this is the colored, then at the same PN junction, both semiconductors, so we are using now photocarbon. The top of the one, there's a tail here, the tails are here, then we put, we insert the CNT, carbon nanotube, into the thing. Suppose this dye molecule, then we put carbon nanotube here. Then it is a very highly conductive one. Electrons, after the light absorption, a lot of electrons are also created. Then very quickly come through the carbon nanotube over the top of the upper content. It's, then originally we synthesized everything. Yeah, even the fabrication method, the material phase of cuprous oxide, everything originally we produce in our labs. Yes. Then this is the device we explained.
Why I ask that question is, yes. Our symposium we published on our technique of doing ISAT.
Okay.
That's why I asked.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. We can measure years and years. We have a solar cell, we fabricate that one, 1996, still operating. The first is higher, it's very, in case of silicon solar cell, it's not easy to prepare in our labs also. But this one is very easy to prepare, because if we are going to follow our economic development, we have to find our ways. Then it is very easy to fabricate this one. Even our undergraduate students, they are coming to our labs, our nano lab, and they are doing their experiments. Our main thing is human resource development for the nanotechnology. That is PhD programs. Professor, you already visited our labs.
Yes.
Then we are searching people, even KDU, that we are inviting to our laboratory. We are not only doing only solar cells, we are doing everything. Even your nano coatings for your flight surface, there are so many things. The solar cells, so to attach the flight wings, everything we are searching. Not only solar cells, we are doing DNA research, we are doing activated carbon, we are doing graphene, we are doing nanomaterials, we are producing hydrogen from water for energy, everything. It's a very pleasure to come here. Going that way, we are linking each other. Even KDU, come to our laboratory, do a PhD. Very nice. We are inviting openly to you. Yeah.
Thank you.
One question regarding the UGV robot. What are the targeted applications for this?
Yeah, this, as we mentioned, it is very difficult to reach higher places in when we are considered in household activities. If we, as example, we considered if an old woman in a house will need to reach a higher place through a ladder to do some activity or to see what is in the upper places. So she could use this small device. It is portable. It is reliable to use. So she could just press a button. The vertical movement will take place, and the camera mounted at the end of the horizontal bar will show what is in the upper side of that she want to see. And the disabled people also can use this, and possible dangerous places that we are want to visit, a drainage system or something, we can detect and we can apply that into those positions.
Great, thank you.
Thanks. There's no answer. The question raised, no?
Yeah.
can get wind up, no? I think we are almost come to the end of the discussion. And are there any questions so far not replied by the panel? No. No. So then, I think it is my duty to sum up this session. We have had very interesting presentations in relation to RFID localization estimation by Madanga and Parukas, and then also solid state photovoltaic cell made from copper in Cu2O, and also using nanotubes. Very interesting work and work at the YMU University, and a household utility robo for which a model is the animation model, and anyway concepts look very very beautiful. And also modeling robo navigation, and which was also very 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 interesting. And this was presented by Chandima and Alpana. I thank them all for the very nice preparations made and for the presentation. Maybe give a clapping hand to everyone who presented those. Right? Shall we wind up the session? Anything else? Pardon? Ah, okay. Come here, come, please come.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we have come to the end of the Electronics, Telecommunication and Information Technology Session 4. It is time to sum up the session. Now I would like to invite Professor KKYW Pereira, the chair of the session, to present certificates to the presenters. RDAA Rajapaksa. Ms. K. Medi Ebru. Mr. DMNSC Disanayake. Mr. K. Malpana, Ms. R. M. J. K. C. Rajaguru,
ladies and gentlemen, now it is time to witness another remarkable event in International Research Conference 2014 of General Sir John Kothalawal Defense University. As all of you know, technical sessions in engineering disciplines themed to achieving development goals through research and innovation in engineering. During all technical sessions, there was an evaluation going on to select the best paper out of all engineering sessions. As we received very high amount of papers, The scrutinization process was very difficult, but 68 papers were selected to present at the conference. As per the review and evaluation process, 6 papers out of 68 has been selected as the nominees for the Best Paper Award. Namely, they are Optimizing Energy Output at Canyon Hydropower Station, a case study by H.Y. Ranjit Pereira, K.M.I.N. Kuruppu, Analysis of Power Quality Issues Due to the Proposed Solar Power Plants in Hambantota by J.P. Karunadasa, M.D. Ratnasiri, Multi-homing to provide reliable connectivity by Tushar Veerwardhana, Umar Tawfiq and Carmelita Goad. Interaction of EM radiation emitted from mobile phones and the human brain tissues by RMIN Bandara and Tushar Veerwardhana. Airplane performance analysis through CED results by J.I. Abhayagunawardhana and RMPS Bandara. Ladies and gentlemen, let me invite once again Professor K.K.Y.W. Pereira to present the Best Paper Award. I kindly invite our Vice Chancellor, Major General Milind Peris, to accompany our professor. Out of the 6 nominated papers, the Best Paper Award goes to Multi-homing to provide reliable connectivity by Tushar Veerwardhana, Umar Tawfiq and Carmelita Goad.
Now, I would like to invite Major General Milind Peris, Vice Chancellor of General Sir John Kapalawal Defence University, to present a token of appreciation to the chairperson. Thank you, sir. On behalf of the organizing committee, I would like to extend our gratitude to Professor K.K.Y.W. Pereira for chairing the Electronics, Telecommunication and Information Technology Session 4. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the close-up of this session.